What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to make a Rust server with Apex hosting. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. A ton of players around the world enjoy Rust because it involves surviving in a harsh environment with different challenges along the way. But if you aren't looking to play in a public server, or if you just want to play with some friends, you'll need to host your own private world. Regardless of the reason, it can be a difficult task to accomplish, but with Apex, we try to simplify the process as much as possible in our panel. You can also easily customize the settings and install plugins or maps, so let's go over exactly what you need to do to get started. Once you have your server, you're going to head towards the server panel and scroll down to the game file section. Click the drop-down menu and search for Rust in the game list and then select it, and then confirm the changes in the new prompts, including making a new world, and then you can restart the server. Now that you own a Rust server, you of course are going to need to know how to join. Head to your server panel and find the IP address port section and copy its command values. Start up Rust, and when you're in the main menu, you can press F1 and then paste the IP address port command here. Press enter on your keyboard and wait for a successful connection. Head towards Steam ID's website and enter your Steam account username, and then copy the Steam ID 64 values and head back to your server panel. In the top left corner, click Console, and on the next page, you can enter Owner ID, the Steam ID 64 number, and then the username. Press Enter, and after this, you can use the Write CFG command to save the changes. If you ever need to remove an owner, you can use the Remove Owner Steam ID 64 command, or the Remove Moderator Steam ID 64 command. Head into the server panel and enter into customizations from the left-hand side, and on the next page, find the Server Settings section, and below it reveals Server Description, Header, Logo, URL, and Name. Enter any desired information into these fields, and once you're done, return to the main panel and restart the server. To learn more about each of these options, we have separate guides to all of these that will be linked down below. Copy the player's Steam ID 64 value from Steam ID, and then head towards your server panel and enter into the console area. Write the command ban ID, the Steam ID 64 number, their username, and the reason in quotations. Press enter, and then you can confirm that they're banned with the ban list X command. To unban somebody, just use the unban Steam ID 64 console command. Open customizations in your server panel and find the world options. Edit the world size and seed values to what you're looking for, and then return to the main panel and scroll down to the world section near the game file area. Press change world and enter a new name, and then you can restart the server. Head to the UMod plugins website and find the plugin that you want to use. Press download and then head towards your server panel. Enter into customizations and confirm the UMod support is checkmarked, meaning it's enabled. After this, you can return to the main panel and click FTP file access to the left. Once you're there, log in and enter into the OXIDE directory and then open its plugins folder. In the top left corner, press upload and drop the plugin file into the upload area. Once this reaches 100%, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. When adding a lot of plugins and attempting to manage players, OXIDE commands might help by allowing you to easily add permissions to custom groups for users. This makes a default account have limited access to certain commands and functions, meaning that they don't need full admin privileges. Finally, you can also use custom worlds on your Rust server. This allows you and others to experience unique environments, builds, and more. But there are a lot more steps to this process than anything else in this guide, so I do recommend focusing on our tutorial that will be linked down below. Customizing a new Rust server is what most owners do, since it allows you to completely control the settings and the configuration. Whether you install plugins, worlds, or create permissions, there are a ton of potential features that you can implement, and with this guide, it should make things a little bit easier. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.